It is now day 42 of Iceland's latest eruption of the Reykjanes volcano, and despite lava only occasionally being visible above the main vent's now 40-meter or 131-foot-high crater rim, the eruption is still ongoing. In the last week, there was a bit of commotion and misleading details revolving around claims that a second eruption was imminent, likely to occur at any moment when in reality the situation was far less severe. You see, the influx of magma supplying the current eruption has to first go through a magma chamber at 5 kilometers depth, which is centered 4 kilometers west of the active eruption site. It then goes into sections of a 15 kilometer long dike emplaced on November 10th of last year before rising to the surface and erupting. The issue is that magma was intruding into the existing magma chamber faster than it could be drained, which has caused the ground above it to slowly rise. However, unlike during the three previous Reykjanes eruptions, part of the intruding magma is diverting directly to the eruption site, hence its unusual longevity. While during prior months this very magma chamber accumulated molten rock at a rate of 4 to 5 cubic meters per second, since March 16th it has seemingly accumulated at a lesser rate of 2.44 cubic meters per second. When you combine this figure with the estimated 3.01 cubic meters of lava the Reykjanes volcano is erupting on the surface, it suggests that the rate of magma influx has broken a trend and surprisingly increased. When the aforementioned magma chamber reaches between 8 and 13 million cubic meters of molten rock, it causes a seal to its east to break, causing it to run to the east, which has resulted in volcanic eruptions on 4 out of 6 occasions. The current magma chamber contains 8.6 million cubic meters of material and is refilling at an approximate rate of 210,000 cubic meters a day. Thus, while it is true that another magma run event could unexpectedly occur today, it is most statistically likely to produce such an event when it reaches the upper half of the aforementioned threshold. This means that the next magma run could take place anywhere from 9 to 17 days from now, translating to between May 4th and May 12th. However, since we are currently in uncharted territory, there is a possibility that the magma won't move at depth towards the east when this threshold is reached. While highly unlikely to do this, there is a distinct possibility that it could instead intrude upwards right above the magma chamber's center. However, I believe the next magma run is most likely to either reinvigorate the existing eruption, producing spectacular tall lava fountains, or cause the eruption of a separate fissure than the point source which is currently active. And, of course, unlike what some news articles claim, the next magma run event is unlikely to affect anyone outside of Grindavik, the Blue Lagoon, and the Svartsengi geothermal power plant. Despite some stating that eruptive activity has remained fairly constant or even slightly increased during the last 4 days, I believe that a slight drop of around 3% has occurred in the same time period. For my evidence, I would like you to turn your attention to this tremor chart of the Reykjanes volcano. It might look confusing, but the rate of magma movement is best indicated via the 1 to 2 Hertz line colored in green. Note how it has decreased since April 21st. As for the purple line, that mostly represents wind speed, which generally falls below the 1 Hz range at lower velocities, which you can see when I overlay the actual recorded wind speeds during the same time period. Lava during the last several days has once again been pooling against Grindavik's protective dirt lava walls, although so far they have not overtopped or breached these features.